a great song written by a woman who wrote it at the time that her husband was likely to get shot by the sheriff, Sheriff J.H. Blair. Her husband was a union mine organizer, and J.H. Blair and his men were lying in ambush around the house. Florence Reese was inside the house with her children and wrote this song on the back of a calendar. And it's a great song for labor. It's a great thing to keep in mind. Which side are you on? The easy part is, which side are you on? Which side are you on? You can do this. Which side are you on? Which side are you on? One more time. Which side are you on? Which side are you on? Oh, come on, you good people. Good news to you, I'll tell. It's about this good old union that's coming here to dwell. Now tell me, which side are you on?
Fight for equal pay.
And we will have our way. We're workers too, the same as you, and this is what we say. Oh no, you can't scare me. I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union. Oh no, you can't scare me. I'm sticking to the union. I'm sticking to the union. Till the day I die. Joe Hill was a union organizer. We're about to have his 100th anniversary. In his song, it says he's been dead for 10 years. That's because the song was written back in 1925. But he's actually been dead nearly 100 years. He was a union organizer, and he wrote songs. And so he was very famous for that. And during the last year of his life, he spent in jail trying to not get executed. And his final letters, I actually had one in my hand, one of his final letters. And he was famous for saying, "Don't mourn, organize." And he was also famous for saying that he wanted his ashes spread all over the United States, except in Utah. Because he didn't want to be caught dead in Utah. he was a comical fellow. There's a movie called Joe Hill, if you ever get a chance to see it. It's pretty good. This was written by some other guys who appreciated me. I dreamed I saw Joe Hill last night, alive as you are me. Says I, but Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he. Now you can sing this. In Salt Lake, Joe, by God, says I, in standing by my bed, they framed you on a murder charge, says Joe. But I ain't dead, says Joe. But I ain't dead. Skipping to the last verse. From San Diego up to Maine, in every mine and mill, where working folks strike and organize, said he, you'll find Joe Hill. Says he, you'll find Joe Hill. And we'll do the first verse again. I dreamed I saw Joe Hill last night, alive as you are me. Says I, but Joe, you're 10 years dead. I never died, said he. I never died, said he. That's Joe Hill. I'm so grateful that everyone came. Now, welcome to UAW Local 848. That's my local. We have a few people here from Local 848. We've got a few people here from the Transport Workers Union. Let's hear for them. Ooh. We've got people here from TOP, including organizer Allison Greer. We've got the whole force of UFCW 540. Sisters, it's going to take solidarity. We're going to pull together to win. And now I would like to present Kathy Carrillo.
be scared and just be out there like most of us already are. That's it.
Good evening, everybody. How are y'all? Thanks again for coming out. My name is Jana P., and I work for the Make a Change at Walmart campaign. And so we work very closely with the work Walmart workers who are part of our Walmart, as Kathy just came up and spoke about. The latest project that we're working on is what we call Walmart at 50. And so a lot of people might not know, but this is Walmart's 50th anniversary. And so, of course, they have billions of dollars that they put into PR about how great they've been over the last 50 years. But what's important for us to know is the truth, how they've impacted various neighborhoods. They've put small mom-and-pop stores out of businesses, the workers that live paycheck to paycheck. A lot of the things that they do are not what they portray in their public relations. So we have the Walmart at 50 project. We have a Nitro vehicle that's outside. I don't know if many people saw the vehicle, but it's wrapped, has several Walmart associates' faces on it, and we have literally driven this vehicle across the country. Good. So about a month ago, we started in California, and we've hit at least 15 states, just portraying what it's like working at Walmart and how it's not just Walmart associates that are coming together, but folks in the community, like such as yourself sitting out here, we're all coming together to share stories about how we've all been impacted by Walmart. And so one of the cool things about the project is at night, which after this event, we're going to go to a Walmart up the street. I'm not sure where, but Kevin Blair has the details. But we have a projection. So we literally go to the Walmart. We have our big speakers and the big projection and some videos that we're about to show for you momentarily. And we play them on the side of the Walmart. And so, of course, if you're shopping at Walmart or working at Walmart, you're going to hear what's going on. And so it's a great tool that we've been using to get associates more involved and active in the organization, shoppers to learn a little bit more about what we're doing, and just, again, getting everybody together, because it's going to take all of us to make the much-needed change at Walmart. So with that being said, I will show you guys some videos.